Right now, two leaders are removed from their positions at a Madison elementary school after a district investigation. What happened and how parents are reacting. And it's the day after, all across Florida, as rescue and cleanup efforts begin after Hurricane Milton rips across the state, leaving destruction in its wake. Plus, how hospitals nationwide are dealing with a shortage of vital IV bags after damage inflicted by Hurricane Helene. How they're making do until the supply is restored. You're watching News 3 Now at 5. And we begin with breaking news. 23-year-old Caleb DiMaggio has been sentenced to 18 years in prison, along with 15 years extended supervision for killing a man outside the Badger Tavern in May of last year. DiMaggio shot and killed 44-year-old Jason Pritchard with a single gunshot wound to the chest. During initial interviews with the police, DiMaggio said the victim would not fight him and then told witnesses that he shot Pritchard in the heart. DiMaggio pled guilty to second-degree intentional homicide, avoiding a life sentence. A principal and an assistant principal have been removed from their positions in the Madison School District. This comes after months of parent-submitted complaints and a district investigation. Our Maddie Heimsch has been following the story and joins us now. Maddie, what are parents telling you?
Eric, one mom I spoke to today said her daughter faced relentless humiliation and bullying at Southside that left the fifth grader with thoughts of self-harm. But her mom says her biggest bully was her principal.
You really hurt my kid, and I don't take kind with that.
Andrea Shorter-Amos is one of 66 parents who signed her name at the bottom of an 18-page complaint submitted to the school district in the spring, alleging principal Candace Terrell and assistant principal Annabelle Torres created a, quote, chaotic, unsafe, and untenable environment.
And it was like, they're not in jail, they're babies.
Shorter-Amos alleges that not only did her daughter regress academically during her time at the school.
The whole 3 years she'd been at the school, she went back. So now we're working on helping her move forward from that.
But was denied the requirements of her IEP, endured long-term isolation as punishment, and was humiliated in front of her peers, leading to severe bullying. She says when her daughter had an emotional breakdown at school and expressed thoughts of self-harm, Principal Terrell sent minimal communication home and refused to schedule a meeting with parents.
That make your kid feel this small, like you're not worth anything when you come to the school. And for my daughter, she told me, she said she wished that when I would drop her off at school, I just wish that you would just come back and get me.
This week, the district announced the removal of both Terrell and Torres for, quote, the time being.
Good, you got them removed. That's a great thing, so that now the kids don't have to go through this, the future kids. But for the kids who's already gone through it, at the end of the day, that lasts them for the rest of their life.
As of last school year, Southside serves almost 400 students, 75% of which are economically disadvantaged, and approximately 80% of which are students of color. Shorter-Amos says she hopes the newly appointed interim principal is able to serve Southside students with compassion.
When I give my kid to you, I like to get them back the way I gave them to you.
We reached out to the district for comment today. A spokesperson told us, quote, personnel matters are confidential.
Maddie, thank you. A warm Friday coming, and then have your jackets and sweatshirts ready by the weekend. Alex is on the weather patio with more details.
Yeah, that's a great way of putting that, Eric. Shorts to fall like a tire in the span of just a couple of days. You could do shorts outside right now. It's beautiful out here on the patio. Temperatures are in the low to mid 70s across all of southern Wisconsin. Let's take a look at those temperatures that we have out there right now for the rest of our evening as we plan together. 67 at 6 o'clock. I'll be here. Jacob will take over later this evening at 10 o'clock. Temperatures will be only in the upper 50s. Remember, low to mid 60s are our normal highs for this time of year. We're going to wake up as we track our temperatures, 50s for the most part, all the way up into the lower 80s across a good portion of southern Wisconsin. And then we have some changes that we're going to talk about. As we get into the weekend, showers on Sunday and frost early next week. I'll show you just how widespread that frost potential is in Maine weather.
Alex, thank you. And you're taking a look now at time-lapse videos from cameras along the Florida coastline and through Tampa as Milton made its landfall last night. Government officials down in Florida say that at least a dozen people have now died in the storm so far as the rescue attempts continue. Now, luckily, the storm surge was far lower than officials officials feared. However, flooding in some areas is still a major concern, as places like St. Petersburg were hit with 18 inches of rain. Search and rescue operations are now underway. The powerful storm made landfall near Siesta Key as a Category 3 hurricane last night, as stories of heroism and loss pour from the state. New video from the Hillsborough County Sheriff's Office, that's where Tampa is, captured this team saving a 14-year-old who was found floating on debris. Even before making landfall, the storm spawned more than two dozen deadly and destructive tornadoes and now has left behind dangerous conditions and hazards that people cannot see.
Every other street, if it's not power lines and trees, it's literally floods.
Standing water can conceal down power lines and other hazards. Standing storm waters can also carry a bacteria that can lead to fatal infections.
That's Florida Governor Ron DeSantis. He says over 80,000 people were in shelters as Milton hit the state. And President Biden says the federal government is sending the resources needed to help impacted communities recover and rebuild. Wisconsin continues to be a major stopping point for presidential candidates and their surrogates, as three high-profile visits are expected in the next 4 days now. In an announcement made just today, vice presidential candidate Minnesota Governor Tim Walz will be making his first stops to the northern part of the state on Monday. And Governor Walz will stop in Eau Claire and then Green Bay to discuss the implications of a Project 2025 agenda. And Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders will be in Baraboo and then in Superior on Saturday. First Lady Dr. Jill Biden will be somewhere in Madison on Monday, though specific details of that visit have not yet been released. Social Security recipients will see their monthly payments go up by just 2.5% next year. The steady decline in inflation limits the annual cost of living adjustment. It's according to the Social Security Administration. For nearly 70 million retirees, payments will go up by about $50. Adding to a total of about $2,000 a month. This adjustment is significantly lower than the nearly 9% increase last year. Officials say the adjustment is centered on an inflation metric from the third quarter of the year. We're a little more than a month now into the school year, and for seniors, it is the last year before they head out into the world to navigate the next steps of their lives. Sarah Cutler with the Wisconsin Virtual Academy says seniors should start planning, if they already haven't, to build the skills necessary for the career they want to have. And Destinations Academy counselor Tanya Steger says that gap years are becoming a more common idea in students she works with.
I guess that I have noticed a trend of students just feeling like they want a break, like they are not necessarily wanting to pursue college as much as I think that I know I was when I was in high school. So it seems to be trending a little bit that students are wanting to wait before pursuing college and maybe try to make sure that they have enough money to pay for college.
Steger says students should be in talks with their counselors and educators about the different options for scholarships, financial aid, and other programs if they're interested in attending college. Wisconsin is outpacing most states when it comes to river dam failures. While extreme rain events have become more common, Wisconsin is ranked second nationally in the number of documented dam failures since the year 2000. However, according to a study from the Wisconsin Policy Forum, the rating of our state's most critical dams has improved. Of the 4,000 dams that are spread across Wisconsin, 34 have failed in the last 24 years. 28 of those failed in just the last 6 years. Consumer Reports is calling for a national ban of infant walkers amid several infant deaths and thousands of injuries in the U.S. and Canada. Consumer Reports joins the American Academy of Pediatrics in asking for this ban. These sit-in baby walkers were banned in 2004 in Canada, and several other nations have also called for bans. In the United States, the Consumer Product Safety Commission cannot impose a ban unless it is specifically directed to by Congress. A critical part of medical care is now in short supply following the wake of Hurricane Helene. Hospitals around the nation are now grappling with a nearly 60% decline in IV bags. Stephanie Stahl reports.
It's a mainstay of medicine. IV fluids are used to hydrate patients and deliver medications, but the solution of sterilized water and salt is in short supply. That's because Hurricane Helene damaged the North Carolina facility, Baxter International, that's the leading supplier of IV bags.
This is precious now. That's why I won't take it out of the bag to show you.
Dr. Jonathan Stahlkamp, the chief medical officer at Mainline Health, says the system that includes four acute care hospitals uses about 1,000 IV bags a day. But now, because they're being allocated by the federal government, it only has half of its normal supply.
It means we have to change how we do business. It means we have to go ahead now and change how we hydrate patients. We're encouraging a lot more patients now to give them a bottle of Gatorade.
The American Hospital Association says there are already substantial shortages impacting patients that are expected to get worse. The association is asking the Biden administration to declare a national emergency to ease restrictions on supplies. The Department of Health and Human Services has said it's evaluating a number of options.
Certainly something that's affecting hospitals across Pennsylvania and quite frankly, across the United States.
Christopher Chamberlain with the Hospital Association of Pennsylvania says if the shortage gets worse, some hospitals may have to delay procedures that aren't urgent.
Looking at elective procedures, elective surgeries, and maybe postponing them for now. Now, the challenge is those are short-term strategies.
Most hospitals are now imposing conservation measures, only using IV fluids for critical needs, hoping the government quickly finds a solution for the shortage.
And several manufacturers around the world are now rushing to increase production to help meet the needs of the United States. Baxter International said it plans to restore the damaged facility in phases and return to full production by the end of the month. Well, right now you can nominate your business for Madison Magazine's Best Places to Work 2025 competition. This year's program will be a little different. Winners will be celebrated along with the Best of Madison Business Award winners at an annual luncheon. It's not all about winning. Anyone who submits their business will be able to see what their employees think about their workplace.
It's a good way for businesses just to see how they're doing, and they get all of the survey results back. And again, it's completely free for businesses to participate. So it's a good way to just get feedback from your employees on how you're doing.
And nominations for the Best Places to Work are open through tomorrow. You can go to madisonmagazine.com to nominate your business, and you'll get more details after that. The winners will be in the March 2025 issue. Chief Meteorologist Alex Harrington returns next with his complete forecast, which starts heading in a fall-like direction soon, and why the northern lights are becoming more visible, and some tips on how to make sure you can catch a glimpse of this natural phenomenon that's just ahead. And the markets all finish in the red today. The Dow Jones losing 58, the NASDAQ down almost 10. The S&P 500 tumbles a dozen, and we'll be right back.
You're watching News 3 Now, brought to you by Cardinal Heating and Air Conditioning.
Spas, spas, spas. The Swim Spa Hot Tub and Sauna Show is this weekend only. Rows and rows of spas, hot tubs, cool tubs, and swim spas. The largest display in the state. Save up to 60% on all in-stock models. This weekend only in the Exhibition Hall at the Alliant Energy Center in Madison.
When my husband got throat cancer, it wasn't just a health crisis. It was a financial one for my family. And that's something rural families know all too well. Joan Bollwig voted against expanding affordable health care for rural families and against bringing drug costs down. And that's one reason I decided to run against her. I'm Sarah Kieski, and I'm running for state senate. Because when someone you love needs medical care, the last thing you should have to worry about is how to pay for it.
Think Sloan's first.
We've been with Sloan Implement since my father started farming, my grandfather started farming. They are a family business that's been around for generations, and that's very important to us.
Think Sloan first, now during Gear Up for Fall on a John Deere X350. Built for taking it easy. Get yours with 1.9% for 36 months. Get a John Deere now.
Power up the Sloans.
Think Sloan's first.
With high inflation, working families like mine are hurting, and Kamala Harris helped create this mess. Now, while Americans struggle, Kamala spent our tax dollars putting illegal immigrants up in hotel rooms, and she supported spending our tax dollars to give illegals sex changes. It's not just liberal, it's insane. Kamala Harris can never, ever be our president.
Preserve America PAC is responsible for the content of this advertising.
Quartz takes a different approach to health insurance. We know every life well lived is a journey, and we're here to light the way at every step. That's why for 40 years, we've been alongside the doctors and hospitals who know what their communities need, because they're a part of them, because we're a part of them. There's a fire burning in all of us. Let's ignite it together. Quartz, find your spark.
Prices are up, wages are down. Inflation is crushing Wisconsin families. Yet Sarah Kieski, she supports lifting revenue limits, allowing property tax rates to skyrocket unchecked. Even more radical, Kieski's backers want to ban natural gas to heat our homes, driving utility bills through the roof. Tax hikes and higher prices for families and those living on fixed incomes. That's Kieski's record. Expensive and extreme. Reject Sarah Kieski and her radical agenda.
Spas, spas, spas. The Swim Spa Hot Tub and Sauna Show is this weekend only. Rows and rows of spas, hot tubs, cool tubs, and swim spas. The largest display in the state. Save up to 60% on all in-stock models. This weekend only in the Exhibition Hall at the Alliant Energy Center in Madison.
You're watching News 3 Now at 5.
Welcome back. The Cottage Grove Fire Department says it used around 100,000 gallons of water to put out a hay bale fire. That fire started about 1:30 this morning on Koshkonong Road, just off the interstate. Stoughton Fire Chief Joshua Rip and his crew joined the effort and said it was an extremely large pile of hay. There were no injuries reported, no structures caught fire. Officials say they don't believe the fire was in any way suspicious. One of the most successful actors to come out of the Madison area is giving back to the community, hoping to inspire passion and hope in kids. Johnny Carr is a professional public speaker, published author, and professional SAG actor. He's appeared in shows like Black Mafia Family, Power Book 4 Force, and the film Judas and Black Messiah. Johnny back in the area speaking to students at Verona Area High School, hoping to offer inspiration and let mentors know what students like himself needed.
Just grab us aside and give us some love sometimes when things look a little tough for us, because a lot about my life looked tough for me early on. And if I didn't have those people that said, you know, I see something in this kid, or, you know, your circumstances don't make you who you are, I probably wouldn't be here today.
Johnny became popular in Madison for being the youngest keynote speaker at the Madison Chamber of Commerce Icebreaker event. Well, the sun is reaching a maximum in its nearly decade-long cycle, causing it to be more active and making the northern lights more visible further south. Tonight, almost the entirety of Wisconsin is in the viewing range of the magnetic field phenomena. Good tips for viewing the lights are head away from cities to a darker area, of course, and the further north you go, well, the better chance you have of seeing the lights with your eyes instead of any special gear. If you can't see the lights, hold up your phone's camera to the sky. It can see rays that your eyes cannot. A look now at your first warm forecast. Summer's last gasp, maybe, coming tomorrow. Here's Alex with more details.
Maybe one to two. I got one more in the forecast, Eric, but it's not going to be as warm as tomorrow's. Adding to the northern lights, hey, scan that QR code right now over there, which would be on your left, and this would be my right. Scan that QR code just like Rick did. That's how you can load up your weather photos so that we can show them here right on TV and celebrate these beautiful photos that we often get here at Channel 3000. Thank you very much again, Rick, for that photo. Summer-like Friday, just like Eric said, just how warm we're going to be, I'll show you in a moment here. Then cold front comes through as we move into the weekend with some showers on Sunday, breezy conditions, cool next week. Widespread frost is likely. This is something that you haven't probably seen a whole lot here on Channel 3. We're adding to our SkyCam network. Thank you, Uplands Hills Health, for sponsoring our live Dodgeville SkyCam. Beautiful fall scene. Looks like a lot of the crops have been harvested, at least in this picture here, and that harvest continues across southern Wisconsin with the dry conditions continuing, warm temperatures, which has aided to the ability to get out into the fields. According to my farmer friends, we got 71 in Madison, 73 in Janesville, over in Dodgeville in the low to mid 70s, and 76 right now in Boscobel. Here in Dane County, 71, 72, 73. The winds are pretty light out there right now. Was just out on the patio. What a gorgeous night. Let's plan it together. By the time we get to 8 o'clock, 60 degrees. Jacob will be here a little bit later in the evening for the 10 o'clock newscast. Temperatures right around 56. And all we get to tonight, upper 40s to the low to mid 50s. Remember, normal lows for this time of year are well into the low to mid 40s. So this will feel very warm to start off our Friday morning, low to mid 50s across the area, and then we warm all the way up here, not a misprint, 82 degrees, 83 in Janesville, 79 in Baraboo, and 77 to the northwest in Camp Douglas. Clouds will eventually be on the increase a little bit later on Friday. Cold front coming through here Saturday, going on into the weekend. There are those fall-like temperatures that we've been alluding to here Monday going on into Tuesday. And Eric was mentioning one last bit of summer here. Well, we go back up to 74 degrees next Saturday with a cold front coming through again later in the weekend. Frost is likely. Some of folks have been reaching out to me asking, when are we going to get that first frost here, that widespread one here in southern Wisconsin. Very confident Monday night going on into Tuesday morning. And then again, Tuesday morning, perhaps going on into Wednesday morning. Could even be looking at a hard freeze as this cold front comes through. And we have that stretch of cooler weather that lasts through the early to mid portion of next week with, again, frost chances possibly Sunday night, Monday night, Tuesday, maybe a patchy frost area or two Wednesday night as well before those temperatures eventually start to warm back up a little bit later in the work week. All right, traffic time. Things are going pretty good here, eastbound and westbound. A little bit slower as you head over towards the 39 exchange. A little bit slower than 55 miles per hour reported at 48 miles per hour at US 12. Down to the south, Janesville, things are going A-OK, right around 70 miles per hour and A-OK. Up towards the Dells, around 70 miles per hour. And I say this pretty often, the weather's been so nice lately. If you're out for a drive tonight, just crack the windows open a little bit and enjoy the breeze.
All right, Alex, thank you. As the rescues continue across Florida, pets sometimes need a little help from first responders as well. We'll show you next.
News 3 Now First Warm Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Introducing the new Sushi Lover Madison. All-you-can-eat sushi and hibachi at an amazing price. Now open at Westtown Mall for lunch or dinner. Be sure to try Sushi Lover Madison.
I worked as a truck driver for 36 years.
And then one day I got this letter.
Your retirement will be cut.
Will be cut in half.
You don't forget something like that.
Every paycheck, we put money away.
But because of Wall Street greed, boom, it was gone.
But Tammy Baldwin saw what they were doing and wrote a bill to save our retirement.
Then she fought like hell to pass it.
What Tammy Baldwin did for our families, you don't forget something like that.
I'm Tammy Baldwin, and I approve this message.
He murdered a father of three, sentenced to life in prison. Kamala Harris pushed to use tax dollars to pay for his sex change.
I made sure that they changed the policy so that every transgender inmate would have access.
It sounds insane because it is insane. Kamala was the first to help pay for a prisoner's sex change.
The power that I had, I used it in a way that was about pushing for the movement, frankly, and the agenda.
Kamala's agenda is they, them, not you.
I'm Donald J. Trump, and I approve this message.
Join us at the Madison Fall Parade of Homes, exclusively sponsored by Nuns. Don't miss your chance to visit the area's top newly constructed homes filled with the latest trends and technology. Go to MadisonFallParadeOfHomes.com and purchase your tickets today.
Our retirement savings account is safe because we made the switch to a Medicare supplement plan. We had Medicare Advantage, but had seen too many friends give up the things they love due to unexpected medical expenses. We found a better way.
Building that middle class will be a defining goal of my presidency. Compare that to Trump. He fights for himself and his billionaire friends. He intends to enact a national sales tax, the Trump tax, that would raise prices on middle class families by $4,000 a year. Instead of a tax hike, we will pass a middle class tax cut that will benefit more than 100 million Americans.
FFPAC is responsible for the content of this ad.
They've been rocking audiences for decades. It's Boghat. Performing live November 30th. Take it easy. At Ho-Chunk Gaming, Wisconsin Dells.
I just want to make love to
with special guest, The Empty Pockets. Tickets are on sale now through Ticketmaster. Legendary rock band Foghat. Live in concert November 30th at Ho-Chunk Gaming, Wisconsin Dells. Your odds are better here.
Introducing the new Sushi Lover Madison. All-you-can-eat sushi and hibachi at an amazing price. Now open at Westtown Mall for lunch or dinner. Be sure to try Sushi Lover Madison.
You're watching News 3 Now at 5.
As first responders and volunteers race to help people affected by Hurricanes Helene and now Milton, sometimes dogs and cats need saving too. Amy Kiley looks at some recent heartwarming and occasionally tear-jerking pet rescues.
Rescuers are saving pets as well as people from hurricane dangers in the southeast. In some cases, the heroes are first responders. This dog is lucky Florida troopers untied him from a fence as Hurricane Milton approached.
I don't blame you.
Animal shelters in northern states are also lending a helping paw by caring for dogs and cats who are in the path of Hurricanes Helene or Milton.
This is why we do the work we do, is because we want to help. We want to help pets. We want to help people.
I think it's just, you know, a testament to each animal's resiliency to be able to take in change and be able to just kind of like pivot like
Doc,
this.
Doc, let's go.
Volunteers are getting supplies for the whole family to remote areas of North Carolina devastated from Hurricane Helene.
Pet supplies, cat food, dog food.
Sometimes the assistance goes the other way. Trained dogs help with search and rescue after disasters. And at the Emergency Operations Center in Tampa, the mayor says this cutie is boosting morale.
She's our stress reliever here.
Bulls fan.
I'm Amy Kiley reporting.
And we'll be right back. A final check of your First Warn forecast.
My name is Bill. I am retired. I'm a Marine Corps veteran, and I live here in Wisconsin. I am not a political person, but Eric Covey doesn't understand how important Social Security and Medicare are around here. I'm on Social Security, and Hudvey said he absolutely supported cuts to Social Security and Medicare. Imagine working longer, paying into the system, and then poof, you're paying your bills with less. He knows it. Cutting Social Security and Medicare will cost us. He just doesn't care.
Win Senate is responsible for the content of this message.
Get an 11% rebate on your next painting project at Menards. Dutch Boys Forever Interior Paint and Primer offers powerhouse protection with its stain-blocking, odor-reducing technology. A gallon starts at $29.98 after rebate. Give your space the Platinum treatment with Platinum Plus Interior Paint. Its Stain Shield technology protects your spaces with a performance you'd expect from a luxury paint at a price you wouldn't. Get a gallon starting at $37.99 after 11% rebate.
Save big money at Menards.
This is a hallway. Doesn't evoke much feeling, but to those facing cancer or a complex condition, it feels like relief. Because all the doctors, treatments, and technology you've been fighting to find, they're all right here, under one roof, connected by hallways instead of highways. East Park Medical Center, coming soon. UW Health, remarkable.
Not everyone knows us, but in Wisconsin, Illinois, and Indiana, we are famous in our field. As a Sloan's technician, customer service is our specialty, whether you come to see us or we come to you. We are in the business of supporting your business, and we are highly trained to work on your John Deere equipment. At Sloan's, our loyalty lies with you. We depend on you, and we are proud to serve you. When it comes to service, you can count on us. Remember, think Sloan's first.
It seems like everyone in Washington is either too far left or too far right. I'm Rebecca Cook, and like most folks in Wisconsin, I'm somewhere in the middle. I'll stand up to Democrats to fight for a secure border and stop wasteful spending. I'll stand up to extremists like Derek Van Orden, who wants to ban all abortions with no exceptions. Like you, I'm fed up and ready for change. I approve this message because it's time that we sent one of us to Congress.
He murdered a father of three, sentenced to life in prison. Kamala Harris pushed to use tax dollars to pay for his sex change.
I made sure that they changed the policy so that every transgender inmate would have access.
It sounds insane because it is insane. Kamala was the first to help pay for a prisoner's sex change.
The power that I had, I used it in a way that was about pushing for the movement, frankly, and the agenda.
Kamala's agenda is they, them, not you.
I'm Donald J. Trump, and I approve this message.
Coming up tonight on the CBS Evening News, the death toll grows for Hurricane Milton as power is knocked out for millions in Florida. The cleanup efforts and hundreds of water rescues, plus why President Biden is praising the life-saving measures that he says made a difference. That and more headlines tonight here on the CBS Evening News.
In Texas, a six-year-old is turning lemons into lemonade. This is Verbena, along with her mother, Jessica, organizing a lemonade stand to raise money to help hurricane victims in North Carolina. Inspired by the devastation she saw on TV, Verbena started by donating her toys and then had the idea for this lemonade stand. Verbena's mother says this is a small effort that teaches a big lesson that even a small act of kindness can make all the difference. You'll love to see that. And hopefully we're done with hurricanes for a while and can focus on just our nice, calm, fall-like weather coming this weekend.
A little bit of a roller coaster. We've got to get a little summer first, and if you want.
And then summer maybe next week again.
That's true. Yeah, temperatures tomorrow, low 80s. So you can wear the shorts and the short-sleeve shirt tomorrow, but not for long. Take a look as we head further into the upcoming weekend. 65 Saturday, 59 Sunday. So you'll have the sweaters on Sunday with a little bit of shower activity. Good chance for frost early next week.
All right, Alex, thank you. We're back in 30 minutes with more updates on News 3 Now at 6. Stay tuned now for the CBS Evening News.